Well, if I think back to the streets, not the real streets, not like singing from the floor, you know, like with our stage, and we'd be traveling in this, in our double-decker bus around from town to town. The streets in 1994 was like pretty tough times, you know, because setting up the stage ourselves up and down, and I don't know, just working really hard, organizing everything ourselves. And you come to the town, you tell the newspapers a few weeks ahead, call up the radio stations, and some newspapers would print something, some wouldn't. And then you'd put up posters. Jimmy would get the permissions and organize whatever had to be done. And Joey would take care of the trucks and, you know, whatever. And then Johnny was in charge of the stage and the crew that he had.
Da rufe ich meinen Vater an. Es war so ein Tag am Regnen. Da waren nicht mal 300 Leute. Und ich dachte meinem Vater, guck mal, Vater, die Westfalenhalle ist frei, der 15. Mai. Und Vater sagt, wow. Und dann Joey und Johnny und alles, als ich angefangen zu haben, die haben gesagt, Jimmy, du bist bescheuert. Das gibt mir nie vor.
Das stimmt nicht. Das habe ich nie gesagt. Ich habe gesagt, mach die zweimal. Zweimal habe ich gesagt, nicht ein, ja, ja.
Ich habe gesagt, Jimmy, du bist Spinner. Im Herbst, nicht jetzt. Jetzt fallst du in deine Nase.
Ich.
Ja, und ich, ich folge meinem Vater, den verrückten Blöder.
Und jetzt ist die voll ausverkauft. Mega per neu.
Mamma mia.
Let's get in the sauna, boys.
Boys, Park Hotel Sauna. And we used to go to with our friends to see some concerts in this hall, the Westfalenhalle in Dortmund. We've seen everybody here. We've seen Bon Jovi, we've seen Bruce Springsteen, the World Championship of Boxing, and then we wanted to do it ourselves. And the first time we came in the hall, it scared the shit out of me. And now it's like, after doing it 15 times in the last 2 years, it's like your second living room or something, you know? But, well, let me think. The day of the concert, I remember we came here And us boys wanted to go the night before because we were so excited about it. We just wanted to be there. We wanted to be in the place where we always wished we'd be.
Yeah. And they got all the way down, and they got the rope, and they got up here, they were just walking around.
We saw that night, the crew setting up the sound and the light. It was kind of a feeling, it was a feeling that this was like the end of, you know, the street concerts, the end of setting up and down every day. It's good that we did it. And so when we came here, we just, you know, watched somebody else do it for you. It was a very good feeling. It was a nice feeling.
I was like, wow, this is too big for us. No way. Looking around like crazy. I remember sitting up there watching the championship of boxing, and over there watching Bon Jovi and Bruce Springsteen. We were on this side over here. But this time it wasn't Odie on stage, it was us on stage. And other people were sitting there and there and there. So, no bullshit.
Go, Dada! Hast du mich drin, Angelo?
Ja,
dann ist wieder auf.
Nervous.
How do you feel, Patricia?
Yeah, I'm feeling great, Patty.
Yeah, say the truth.
I do feel great. F*** you now.
Hey. How do you feel, Sean? How do you feel, Barney? How do you feel, John?
Yeah, how else? Cool.
Right. Going on stage. Jim, I got something for you. The key.
You should come back after Nathan. Okay. And again, I don't know.
Let me be. And wearing of the green.
Tuxedo.
It's 3:30, 15th of May, Westfalenhalle, Dortmund, Germany. And you got 15,000 people out there screaming their butts off. And we're just taking our time here, you know. I woke up this morning, I said to myself, what a great fucking day for rock and roll. No, we try not to swear in front of the camera.
It's good. I'm gonna take this out, it's good.
After I talked about the AIDS thing, then I say, wir sammeln heute für eine AIDS-Forschung.
Hast du gesehen, YouTube?
Ja.
Cool, ne? Eines Tages, ich und YouTube in der Toilette. Ich und Bono.
Jimmy!
Hey! Bono! Bono ist hier!
Leave him alone!
Die Security hat es nicht unter Kontrolle.
Ja.
Hat der Reinhard vorne gesagt, bitte seid cool, drückt nicht so nach vorne. Ihr drückt die Leute vorne. Da reagieren die Leute drauf.
Genau.
Weißt du? Okay. Wenn du siehst, irgendwann, er sagt, sind, die Security sind, hat jetzt schon irgendwie.
Vor allem, das sind, nur, das sind wirklich nur, sagen wir, die ersten 20 Meter, ne? Also das sind vorne speziell die ganz harten Fans, die sich da von hinten
genau,
nur
die sich einfach von vorne
aufmalen, ne? Die halten sich
also
nur auf, ne?
Ja,
also
der letzte Mal waren wir 18, ne? In der Wunderhalle waren 18, sind zum Krankenhaus, ne? Und bis jetzt...
Die haben ja jetzt schon 20 jetzt rausgezogen.
20 schon, ja.
So was like, everybody was like, whoa. And then on the show, I remember Jimmy insisted on carrying this cowboy hat because he had seen the video of U2 with this cowboy hat in the Love Town tour. So he like, it was like a must for him. And we all got dressed up and backstage we're all like getting ourselves going, you know, like, yeah, we're gonna go for it. And yes, you tell somebody, how you feeling? He goes, I'm cool. Bullshit, he was nervous in his pants. You know? Finally, we made it. Sold out. 15,000 people. Just us, the stage, in this hall, with 15,000 people. So we're about to get like a, you say in German, a Vorgeschmack.
Are you ready?
Look at me, cause the devil's got me eyes set on me. What's the time, I was feeling blind, but now I'm believing love and you're the reason why. I can't stop the love, no, I can't stop the love you're giving me. Yeah! I have kissed the honey leaves of the red rose spring, now a baby. I did sing with the pure and the free, I have walked
in their hearts. Sometimes I wish
Thank you.
erste Mal seit 3 Jahren ist mein Vater wieder auf die Bühne.
This is something very, very, very important for the family, that my father came on stage, because he stayed at home, because he got a stroke 4 years before that big excitement what happened on stage, that he came with the family. Before we were all together. And this was a dream come true for the whole family, and it was something, of course, very, very emotional. And it was just the high peak of the, of these times that my father came on stage and that was possible for him. He needed a lot of hands, and a lot of people helped, like friends of ours. And I helped him too, and then Patty brought him over to in front, and all the people, they just, you know, they, it just it did it to their hearts, this touched them that so deeply. They really love my father so much, his family, and everything he does, and the way he believes about life and the future. It's just, it was a very special moment. In our lives.
Ihr seid alle klar? Gut, kommt.
Walking on the streets, you look into a dump, you look into a dump, and you say, why, why, why? Why, why, why?
It was a long, long process. We selected out of 3,000 songs, about 25. And then we played those songs on the stage. Those times we were playing live in the streets, like here, you know. And by the time we went into the record, into the studios, we knew pretty much which were the very strong songs, if people liked the songs or not. It was a very, very careful work, and but a lot of, we put a lot of energy into it. I think it's the first record which we felt our live energy came into the tape. So this was a very big step forward for us. The level of composition from everybody was much, much higher, and it was like one unity in the sound. So it's almost like a new thing that happened in the band, but that's something that we worked for many, many years, because we had been working in the streets trying to become the band that we wanted to become. And we think that this record achieved it. And we had a lot of fun in the studio. It's hard work, but we also had a very good help from the studio. It's important to have the highest technique. It's also important to have a musical ambience on the walls. It means everybody who's working around you has to be kind of helping the project. They have to be involved in the project. And the whole team, the technicians, the owner, and so on, they were all fully, fully involved. They were very, very helpful and made it possible that this new sound came out.
First day was in some factory,
yeah,
in somewhere around Essen, in Germany, in Ruhrgebiet. Yeah, we got there. There was all kinds of lighting and cameras, and
we were shocked. We never seen something like that.
This is like like in the movies, you know, like, and you see the making of, you know, he's got these big cameras and people running around.
We made one before for Sean R. Kelly, but it was just a spontaneous, just a ball.
Yeah, they just filmed what they saw. But this was supposed to be like a real, you know, like
clip.
Like it starts off at zero, and then the first guitar thing's coming from the first 5 seconds, you have a shot of the guitar, and the next 10 seconds, a shot of somebody singing and stuff like that, yes. You know? So the first clip with like a storyboard type of thing, as cheap as was done, it's still like a great video, and I think that's why we got so many people calling in for saying that that's their video of the year, you know?
Because many people don't see a video like that. They always see a perfect video.
They always see like shots
studios,
changing,
you know?
Like every 3 seconds the shot
like,
changes, like your eyes go like blah, blah, blah.
It was like totally different, this video.
Yeah, we had to make a clip for the song because it was a single out of the Over the Hump record, and so that it could be played on Viva and on MTV. The channels that play the clips, they wouldn't play it because they said it wasn't good enough. So we had to go and cut it again. And then we sent it to them, and they still wouldn't play. We said, okay. Then the promoter, the guy was trying to push the clip. He said, just play it one time because you owe me a favor anyway. So the guy played it one time, and then they got a big response, and they had to play it every day.
And
then it ended up being the most loved video of the year, 1994.
Thank you. show that was on this program in the last 2 days, I tell you that. It was the biggest act until now. They really blasted it. No? They really did. They're killing them. Big party. I enjoyed every minute of it. Yeah. Thank you very much.
First time. All right, Johan.
One thing that was really cool about the Green was that, it's like the whole backstage was full of all these bands like Clawfinger, Aerosmith, I mean all of them there. It was really cool. So it's like you met all these bands and all these drummers. That was one thing that I really liked it. I met the Aerosmith drummer and it was really cool. And it was a real cool show. And the whole public was just it's fantastic. Yeah, you know?
I spawned and honey, I told you. We were very nervous. And we got all dressed and hair dressed. And we got to meet Clawfinger and Four Non Blondes. And they were so cool. I mean, they were really nice. It was really great. And when we were on stage, it was incredible because There was only like 2,000 people in front, and the rest was just laying down, going like, who the hell are these group coming up? And so we just said like, okay, let's have fun, and then we started playing, and I think that was one of our best concerts ever, till now. And I don't know, the feeling was incredible, and then the place got more and more full. I mean, the place in the end was just, I mean. And then in Take My Hand, you saw these big guys, tattoos everywhere, taking their hands. It was incredible. It was really nice. It was really incredible. It was a great experience for us because
we know we can rock 40,000 rockers. So that was for us a kind of a proof that we're a rock band.
RTL präsentiert. Candy Family mit ihrer Band Neuwander City Christmas for All. Die Wander City für alle. Die Candy Family Christmas for All. Das ideale Geschenk.
It's more Weihnachten. Bring the best stuff.
Merry Christmas.
Christmas for all.
Just like here, and we have to pretend, oh, look, red-nosed reindeer, dear, or whatever, something like that. And then I think that was the first spot that I ever worked with. We've done a few spots, but I was not there. I think that was Patty and Johnny, and Patty had to repeat it 15 times. They only showed it 3 times, but I saw him, he repeated it 15 times, yes. Always when we do videos, every time we do a video, every time we do something for TV or something, and Joy and I have to do something, Joy always hits me. And this time he hit me again. Now listen up, kids. I want to get that guy. I want to get him. I'm going to strangle him. I want to make him. I want to show him on TV next time who I am.
RTL präsentiert. Die Family mit ihrer brandneuen Weihnachts-CD Christmas for All.
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer had a very shiny nose.
Die Weihnachts-CD für alle.
Santa Maria.
Die Kelly Family Christmas for All. Das ideale Geschenk.
It's more Weihnachten. Bring the best stuff.
Merry Christmas.
And a Happy New Year.
To the hotel, and you're gonna leave a motor.
motor on just in case something happens.
He gave me the key. He explained me how to close the doors and everything.
So damn hot.
City, and in the nighttime we would pack up, of course, the stage, everything, you know, the stage, the beer wagons, the cassette wagons, and the equipment, the lighting equipment, and we pack it up, and then in the middle of the night, and then we sleep like 4 hours or 3 hours, and then next day we set it up in the morning, and then by 12 o'clock we'd have the first show, and then at 3 o'clock the second show, and then I think we make a Mittagspause because of the weather, and then in the evening we give the big show, you know, like 3 or 4 shows a day. And it was a very hard time, but it was a very, very, very interesting time, very good time, because we had this special kind of energy. It's like just, we didn't even think. We were just doing it, you know, we didn't even think. We were not thinking, you know, we were, if today I wouldn't do that. I don't even have the energy. Psychologically, I wouldn't do it. Today, I mean, I need my catering. I need, you know, we didn't have any catering, you know. Hey, we would eat borscht, or actually Maite, she used to cook. Maite used to cook in the bus. We had an oven, and we had some food there. And yeah, Maite used to cook. She used to make whatever, soups or goulash, you know. Like in the middle of the night, we'd be setting up like 3 o'clock in the morning. Maite would come in with a big bowl of goulash, and you know, that's really good. That's like, you know, like a good bean soup or something we would eat. And yeah, so maybe we were like healthy healthy blacks in the south of America. They're just working and eating, but it was not just work, it was also, the concerts were very good.
working very hard on stage and giving a lot of energy and doing a lot with a lot of people, and there's always something going on. The ship is just a perfect place to go out, and you really feel really free, and you can really relax. And I don't know, it's just, you get very inspired and you can work already on new songs, and there's no worries and no hectic, no stress. So I think a ship really gives you that feeling, just that perfect feeling. I mean, other people, they go on vacation for 3 weeks to get out of that stress. And with a ship, you just go 3 days, and it feels like you were gone for like 3 months. Because it's just, I don't know, it's beautiful. Go out with a ship. You really get that. I mean, it's really important, this job, to really get rested out, because you're doing so much. I mean, there's always something going on. Like, you'll see. There's always something, and there's always, and we're so many people, we're a big family, there's always this and there's that. And so that's why that trip was very special, 3 days, just relax.
Musik ist das Markenzeichen der Familie Kelly. Seit Generationen schon. Und die Musik wird immer erfolgreicher. An diesem Wochenende, da wurden die Kellys von ihrem eigenen Erfolg sogar überrannt. Michael Möller und Wolfgang Wiewold berichten.
Drei Mitglieder der neunköpfigen irischen Folkgruppe singen Samstagabend aus einer Zeltwand heraus. Draußen flammen Wunderkerzen auf, bei den Fans fließen die Tränen reichlich. Die eigentliche Bühne im 2000-Mann-Zelt aber blieb leer. Das Konzert musste abgesagt werden.
weil das einfach so viele Menschen waren. Über 10.000 Menschen ringsrum um Zelt und das Zelt hat nur Kapazität für 2.000. Das ist einfach zu gefährlich.
Während die Gruppe zusammen mit den Ordnungsbehörden nach einer Lösung sucht, lassen sich draußen nur wenige Anhänger ihr Eintrittsgeld zurückgeben. Die meisten sind verständnisvoll.
Die Kindlis, die können nichts dafür. Nein. Dass sich die anderen da mit reingedrängelt haben, ohne Karten. Ich meine, das ist eine Sauerei.
Dann nach 2 Stunden die Entscheidung.
Morgen finden hier auf diesem Platz 2 Open Air statt. Eins um 15 Uhr, eins um 19.30 Uhr. Der Eintritt zu diesen Konzerten ist frei.
Sofort beginnt die Gruppe mit dem Abbau der Bühne, um sie nach draußen zu verlegen. Sonntagnachmittag dann das versprochene Gratis-Open-Air-Konzert. Und wieder platzt die Stadt aus allen Nähten. 10.000 sind gekommen und wieder fließen die Tränen reichlich.
The success was growing more and more day by day in the street concerts. So we decided to go in a different way. And that was with a tent, with a circus tent. We wanted to develop a show, a better show, a stronger show, and do something different, you know. So we decided to go with a tent. The first 2 tent concerts was Münster and Bochum. And they were Münster. It was a very, very shocking situation. People were pushing so much. It came to a point where just people just rushing, pushing, and then you can see Jimmy and Patricia try to slow the people down and telling them, please, you know, don't kill yourselves. And I remember I was on stage with a microphone and telling the people, slow down and don't, you know, keep it down, you know, don't rush so fast. The people were just, you know, they were in such a state. It's just the kids were just such a state that they didn't listen. They didn't even see Patricia and Jimmy Kelly next to them.
It changed our lives. We knew that something had happened, which we had to take different measures of security for ourselves, for our fans. If we wanted to keep on doing concerts, we would have to organize everything totally different. So we asked our A&R man, Mike Ungefähr, who are the best security men in Germany. Who takes care of Take That? Who takes care of Michael Jackson and guys like that when they get over here? And the name came out, the Special Security Service in Bonn, because the key points, these men know what to do with our crowd. We have a crowd that goes between 5 years old up to 50, so it's much different than other groups. Other groups have a certain age level, a certain weight level, our crowd is very different. So if a little kid gets crushed against a crash barrier because some adult is pushing, usually you can't see him. But our men are very aware of what we have for problems, and nothing has ever happened because of this, because they know our crowd very, very well. So this is what happened.
And so we were very happy after we got the security and we solved the whole problem. We were very happy, very relieved, because we could go on, we could concentrate on our music, and nobody would get hurt. And that was for us very important.
So is Patty in Ashton. So is
Patty.
Backstage message.
So ist wirklich Patty. So ein Penner.
What the hell is this? No privacy around here? Chuck, give me a picture.
Dann müsst ihr das sagen, das machen wir halt abhängig, wie du reagierst. Müsst ihr machen.
Ja,
nein, müsst ihr nicht. Also ich sage nur.
Ja, dann musst du den Plan vorbereiten, immer so. Da geht nicht live, oder?
Das nicht.
Ein paar Gitarren vielleicht, wenn ihr wollt. Das sagen wir, wir
singen. Hey, man mag das Work.
Then Santa Maria, and then Happy Christmas, and then we have the world at the end. That's what I wanted. Mike, wir wollten eine andere Reihenfolge haben.
Bitte?
Here's Chana
Claus.
Here's Chana Claus. Can we play something for him, boy? To take us? Oh, hi.
Hi.
Merry Christmas
Sarah.
To all of you.
You're Santa Claus?
Well, his wife. Oh, yes, a boy sent a letter and he wishes. What did he wish? What does he wish? Shit.
TV. Game Boy.
I want no pimples on my face on Christmas Day. Okay? Now, if that happens, I know you exist. Otherwise, I'll disbelieve the dream of Santa Claus. You don't want me to do that, do you?
Eh?
Yeah!
Yeah! Yeah, Shani, bro. Shani, bro. This is a Heimspiel for Shani. Heimspiel.
Yeah! Vor zwei Jahren waren wir hier. 500 Meter weiter haben wir einen ganzen Monat gespielt.
Am Weihnachtsmarkt.
Weihnachtsmarkt, da.
Mhm.
Ja. Und 500 Meter weiter war der kleine Shani geboren.
Ich hatte ja schon gesagt, der hat das hier gekriegt.
Und auf den Tisch da hatte ich die Weihnachtstournee organisiert.
Wo?
Soll ich das nehmen oder?
Ja. Im anderen Zimmer.
What else do we have for instrument? Two congas, a drum set.
Ah, yeah. Genau, da müssen wir Pappe da reinstecken. Ne? Hat jemand was zu essen geholt?
All I want for Christmas is my two front teeth. And all she wants is Christmas.
Hier haben wir so eine kleine Bühne aufgebaut, zwei Podesta und ein paar Instrumenten, ein paar Mikros, zwei kleine Lautsprecher und Generator an und hier gespielt, was passiert da.
Und dieser Weihnachtsbaum war unser Backstage. Wir haben gespielt für 300 Leute, die sind alle hier und in der Mittagspause haben wir mal Döner da gegessen. Der gleiche Stand ist immer noch da. Da oben war mal eine Kneipe, die ist jetzt nicht mehr da.
It's getting dark.
We sing in this cold with jackets and pants.
Ja, Erinnerung, komm.
I see. I die.
Oh,
oder gut. Die haben ja auch gegessen.
Ramona!
Ja, voilà. Immer gleich im Typen. Ja.
Genauso gut wie damals.
Lisa, give me one.
Früher gab es mehr Tomaten drin.
Thank you.
can't imagine how beautiful it is to sing for people and to see a smile, a tear in their eye. You don't know what that person has gone through that day. Maybe he just had a divorce. Maybe he just had a fight. Maybe he just shot himself a heroin syringe. You can't see. When you sing them a song, you see it in their eyes. You see their suffering and you see their joy. Somehow music brings it all out. They can't bottle it up more, like a bottle of wine. The cork pops out.
Working very hard at a place in the Rhine called Sangoa. And so this was like the beginning of starting to do a little bit of acting, because actually they wanted the guy who did the register, who helped us, Volker, he wanted to hire like professional actors to do the side scenes. To the side scenes with the different things like the fighting or the walking back and forth or running or these different scenes, and we said no, we want to do them ourselves. And he did not believe that we could do it, but actually he was very, very satisfied. It was better than if we would have hired somebody, because it's really us and fits with us.
Me and Joy, we were doing the sword fighting. Those two guys you see in YYY, sword fighting, it's me and Joy. Now, Joy, what does he do? What do you think he did? We're fighting, right? We're supposed to pretend that we're fighting. We're not supposed to fight. We're supposed to pretend. And he goes and he hits me straight in the head with a real sword right here. With a real sword, like, and I just went like, wow, down. I fell down on the floor. I was like, and I had to sort it myself. Actually.
One, two, three.
you think? It's good?
I proudly present the Patty of the Kelly family.
Is this yours? Do you know where this?
I don't know. I still single.
Oh, I don't know where the shit.
I'm changing my mind every 5 minutes. Believe it or not, my left foot is bigger than my right foot, like a half a centimeter. And one time, these are the shoes. I bought these shoes according to this foot. I put them on, and the toe started hurting on this side. So ever since then, I buy shoes and I try them on the left foot.
Hi, do you think I'm ready to walk?
Yeah.
You are.
So after having a great year of 1994, a hard year, working our butts off, it was like being in Cologne, like I think we did 3 days. I think we did two shows on Sunday, I'm not sure. 3 days, we played in Cologne. And our boat was 5 minutes away. And the last day, I think it was the last day, and my father came to the show. And like Cologne is always like a place where all the friends always come, because it's like half of our friends live in Cologne, and all the business partners. And then we had this this gold party, like over the hump had sold, I think. Something like half a million, or maybe it was even a million at that time, I'm not sure. So it was like the first official gold Verleihung, you say in German. And so my father was like laying down on the bed there, and the people from the record company were handing out these golden things to everybody, and to the studio, to Hartmut, to Mike Ungefähr, everybody involved, even Waldemar got one. The guy that passes the hat.
Dieser erste goldene Award ist für Patricia als in Vertretung der gesamten Kelly Family.
A time when we hear a certain call, when the world must come together as one. Someone